In 1989, while working on exhibits for Boston Science Museum, I was playing with some glass mirror tiles. You can just buy these at hardware stores. Here's the camera. Ooh. Breaking the fourth wall. But I came up with a couple of cool things you can do. Like the Exploratorium Science Museum has their gravity mirror, where you have a huge mirrored wall and you stand halfway between. Well, you can really screw around with your face using mirrors. But I wanted something more serious, and I found you could have three mirrors, or four, but three is simpler, three mirrors standing on a table like this, and you would get a sphere if they were tilted out slightly. So I built this thing that made a sphere. This is like a prototype for an exhibit that you would stand inside of, and it would make a planet with variable size. Oh, there's the light. And if you put this thing against a wooden table, you would get a nice looking wooden sphere. See, this is basically a three-sided kaleidoscope. So rather than making it an infinite plane of triangles, it makes like geodesic domes. I'm gonna mount the camera better here. Nice clean wooden sphere. And if I move it a little off the edge, it starts making like a geodesic dome. But what's that? Maybe it's sort of biological. I stuffed my fingers in there too. Well, that was only the beginning, because we don't even need the wooden sphere, just fingers. Fingers. It gets very biological. How biological? You have no idea. Yes, you do. Eyeball. Oh boy. And, of course, this is a perversion of nice pristine geometry and is immediately dubbed the DISGUSTOSCOPE. These things are very easy to make. You don't even need the glass cutter cutting up 12-inch mirror tile, because if you go to a glass store, you can buy scraps of plexiglass mirror. Also, tap plastic stores will have mirror scraps in their bin. And that cuts up just with any kind of saw. Here's a little plastic one.
DISGUSTOSCOPE.
And here's a tiny one made from like 32nd inch. Now the lighting, you can see with this one, the lighting works great outdoors, but indoors these things sort of shield themselves. So you can use them as great outdoor toys, but indoors you have to find the just the right direction for overhead lights. So it's actually worthwhile rigging them with some kind of light. These I've put little $1 LED battery assemblies from the dollar store, so they have their own spotlight.
More information and plastic cutting dimensions are available on the Science Hobbyist website.